back, guys. I'm going to be making this simple sandwich. It doesn't take much at all. But goodness, this is something different from what you've always had. I'm using just basically tomatoes and some onions, which I added some salt, oregano, and some chili flakes too, depending on the level of heat you like. So if you're someone that you don't really like a lot of pepper, you might skip this out. If you like pepper, add more. Whatever you decide, whatever you like, just add as you wish. So I just gave this a good stir. Like, I mixed everything together to make sure that all my ingredients were all together and nothing was going to be separate. After mixing this, you want to set this aside while you get ready for the next step. So the next thing to do is to butter our bread, because we're going to be like toasting this lightly on a grill pan. So I'm just like buttering one side. You don't need to butter the two sides. It's just the side that is going to be on the pan you need to like butter, so that it doesn't burn and all that. And what I'm doing next is to like apply or use some butter on my grill pan as well. You don't want it to burn. We are going to be toasting it and it's going to be staying for some time. So you want this to like toast very well. So I'm going to be doing this in two batches. Don't worry, please just watch this video from the beginning till the end. You understand what I mean later on. So on one side, which I didn't butter, I'm adding my tomato onion mix. You know, the side that I buttered is what is on the pan, you get? That's the side you're going to be putting on the pan. And the other side, you apply your mix. So I added that and I added some cheese slice. You can skip this if you don't want to. If you notice what I did, the other side is going to be on top, the other side of the buttered, because you're going to be flipping it all together. So you're going to be flipping the sides after about 2 to 3 minutes when one side has like cooked. And guys, I regretted using this bread. Bread is expensive, but yes, I don't even understand. Like, this bread was so light. I would advise you to use thick bread or thick loaves. If it's very light, it won't form very well, but that's not the fault of anybody. That's just the fault of the bread. Let's just attribute the fault to the bread. You'll see what I mean later on, because I remember that I had like a better one in my freezer and I just whipped it out, because this one was so light, it was just falling apart and I was like angry, like, what is all this? So I'm repeating the process. I had to stop and I had to go search for more bread, and thankfully I'm so happy. Yeah, if you can notice, this one is a lot thicker. The thicker, the better. That's just it. Unfortunately, this is what the world is going to now. People are trying to like cut down so that you don't have to spend so much, but I had this thicker loaf, which I appreciate. You'll see that this one will flip very well. Like, this one was whole and it stayed well, which is what I want. This is what I want for my sandwich. This is what I want for my bread. I don't want the one that will be falling apart. That other one was so light, so it couldn't hold, it couldn't like take shape or hold form. This one is a lot better. I'm sure you can see the difference. Basically, like I said, it's nobody's fault. Well, we just have to adapt to the way things are going on now. We just hope things will get better. Even bread is taking the heat. So guys, my sandwich is ready, my tomato onion sandwich, and I just cut into it. You can just cut it diagonally, just the way I'm doing in this video. And you can see this one was a lot better. Like, I was so glad I had this bread in my freezer, and can enjoy it with some yummy ketchup and any other thing you love. Thank you so much for watching. Kindly share, kindly subscribe. I'll see you in my other videos. Bye.